Good morning, Joseph, Jonah, and Sebastian. Joseph, I hear the sad news that you're leaving the 16th of April. I will certainly miss you. I will send work for you to finish the semester wherever you are. And I hope the best for you. Jonah, I saw your algebra worksheet saying, I don't take algebra, and it was blank. I understand. I spoke with the principal and hopefully they fixed that and gave you some geometry work. Sebastian, I am sure that you are missing playing chess. So sorry about that. For today's lesson, you will need a pencil and your worksheet. That's all that you need, and yourself. Today we're going to see biconditional statements. This is right where we left before we took the break. So the definition that you had to fill in your worksheet is a conjunction of a condition and its converse. Don't worry, conjunction is when you add two statements with an and. That's why you have a condition in your worksheet. If P, then Q. So if something happened here in the hypothesis, then you have a Q, right? The conclusion. And conjunction means that it's and, and we symbolize and. That's a conjunction. So a biconditional has a condition. This is the condition. And the inverse, the converse of a condition is just the same, but inverse. It means if Q, then P. This is written in your worksheet. So if P, then Q is a condition, and the inverse of that, if Q, then P. So if those both are true, the way we symbolize that biconditional statement is P and Q, and this is what you have to write. It both goes ways. So this is what you need to write on your worksheet. You also need to write some definition. Now, the last part that you need to fill in, a biconditional statement is true when both, that's the word that goes there, when both the conditional, the conditional and the converse are true. Those are your words to fill in. A biconditional statement is true when both the conditional, if P then Q, is true, and the converse, and the conjunction, the converse is true. Okay, let's look at some examples now. If you need time, you can pause the video in any moment, ask your staff, and then you can fill in. The first example, two angles are supplementary. Supplementary means that they add to 180, Joseph. Two angles are supplementary if and only the sum of their measures is 180. Now, these are biconditional statements. They are asking you to write the condition and the converse, and then to decide whether or not they are true. So let's see. Let's start with the condition. I think that's what you have. What is the condition here? Remember the condition, if P, then Q. The condition, let's take the first part. If, always start with if two angles, I'm going to put this, are supplementary, then, here comes the conclusion, their measure, then the sum, the sum of their measure is 180 degrees. Here is the condition. The converse, we're just going to switch. So let me write here the converse. So if two angles. I'm going to change the words. Add up to 180 degrees. Then they are supplementary. They are supplementary. See how I switch? First, I put the two angles. If two angles are supplementary, then the sum of their measure is 180. The converse, if two angles add up to 180, then they are supplementary. And then you need to determine the truth value. Is this true or false? It is true when both the condition and the converse are true. That's how we know when a biconditional statement is true. So is the condition true? The condition is true. Is the converse true? If two angles add up to 180, then they are supplementary. It is true. Therefore, the truth value, I'm going to write it here, because I ran out of space, as you see, is true. And you need to decide why or why not. It's true because both or conditional and converse are true. That's the reason. Number two says, I wear my snow boots if and only if snows. So let's write the condition. The condition is the first statement. If, always start with if, both condition and converse. If I wear my snow boots, then it snows. With the two statements. If I wear my snow boots, then it snows. The converse, the opposite. If snows, then I wear my snow boots. What is the truth value of these biconditional statements? Are they both true? Is the condition true? If I wear my snow boots, then it snows? That's not true. Just because I wear the boots doesn't mean that it's going to snow. How about the converse? If it snows, then I wear my snow boots. That's more likely. So the condition is not true. Therefore, the truth value of the biconditional is false. Both needs to be true in order to be true. And why? Because the condition is false. You have really two more to do, not much, but I believe number one uses something like x squared equals 25, then x needs to be equal to 5, something like that. Remember that when you have this, you need to substitute the value of x, the 5, over here. And then exponents is how many times the base, which is this one, repeats. If the base is 5, it's going to repeat 2 times, which means 5 times 5. So you will need a little bit of algebra over here. And that's it for today. Enjoy, have fun. And we look forward to receiving your assignments.